Hello everyone, welcome to Clueless Insanity. We are traveling towards Hasan in the beautiful Bengaluru-Mangaluru highway. The weather is beautiful and joining with me, Abhishek. And we'll be talking about the Olympics 2024. So, Abhi, what do you feel? Olympics is around the corner, July 26th starting. So, what are India's chances?
See, I'm as excited as driving in this beautiful weather and beautiful road. Same way, I'm excited to see how Indians will perform in Olympics. Being one of the biggest country in the world, it's a little sad to see that we have a very lesser number of participants this year compared to the Tokyo Olympics. Slightly marginal numbers, but still for a country of such population, it is little disheartening to see those numbers. But at the same time, we should be happy that there are multiple sports where Indians are participating, and we would like to see them perform well.
Yeah, I agree to that. But still, we have a very strong 140 member support staff contingent, which is the highest for this in any of the Olympics we have got. So the total contingent we have is a very huge number, and I think the support staff will play a big role in helping the athletes.
Absolutely. See, when it comes to sports where you have a lot of people participating, and also there are different segments, right? When it is individual sports, the support staff increases. For example, wrestling or weightlifting, you'll have multiple people assisting the athletes. Likewise, when it's a team sport like hockey, you'll have a smaller supporting staff, right? So overall, the support staff plays a very important role. We could see what happened in the recently concluded T20 Cricket World Cup. The support staff were also felicitated because their role plays an important part when it comes to winning or losing. And also not just winning or losing, it is more about the mental stability of each individual, for which the support staff role is very important.
Absolutely. Support staff play a crucial role. So just going by the history of Indian medals at the Olympics, so in 1996 we got one medal, which is of Leander Paes in tennis. In 2000, Karna Maleshwari in weightlifting. In 2004, we had Rajwardhan Singh Rathor getting that medal in the double trap shooting. So in 2008, for the first time, we got a gold medal in shooting by Abhinav Bindra, and followed by Sushil Kumar in wrestling and Vijayinder Singh in boxing. And whereas the London Olympics in 2012 was our biggest medal haul, and then a couple of medals in 2016 Rio, so, and of course the last Olympics at Tokyo. So what do you tell about that? That was seven medals which we got, which is our highest tally ever. What do you think of that?
What we are able to see is a lot of individual athletes are winning medals, which is a great thing for Indian sports. At the same time, I hope it's not one up and one down. For example, 2012 was a great Olympics for us, but 2016 turned out to be not that much. And then 2020 was again probably the best in Indian history, right? So going by that standard, I hope lot of people take up sports, and also the encouragement in the country should develop to such an extent that we are sending massive number of people in all sports. And it's also nice to see people participating in equestrian, where we don't get to see lot of Indians participating, right? So these are the developments. At the same time, there are multiple areas where the boards, the individual boards of each sport, there are few complications and issues. If those are sorted, I guess we'll get to see a lot of people. And also, it's not just about contesting, we'll be talking of winning. Right now, of course, we want a lot of medals, but looking at the overall contingent, I feel there are few sports where we are just participating, and medal hope is highly doubtful. But of course, we shall wish them to perform well, and who knows, if it's their day, they can definitely get one of those medals.
Yeah, well I agree with you. It's just that initially we start off participating, and we move on slowly and do better as it goes on through the years, and we have been doing that. Like some sports where we thought it was really tough, say for field hockey, yes, we are once upon a time dominating like anything, but after all, so many years, right, around 40 years if I'm not wrong, we got that bronze last time. So yeah, we are progressing well, and I'm sure we'll be doing really well in this upcoming Olympics. So coming to the individual events, so in weightlifting, we have only one athlete participating, which is Saiko Mirabai Chanu. What do you think about her chances?
See, Mirabai Chanu started off really well last Olympics. She won us the silver medal. And on day one, if something like that happens, it's a huge boost to the contingent, because they stay together as a family when you're going abroad for such a big event. It's a booster, right? So her chances, she's been doing well. She won gold in Commonwealth Games as well. And also, when it comes to athletics and all, which starts off at the later stage, so you have to wait for a long period to get a medal. But Mirabai Chanu's events will be during the earlier stages of the event. And if she manages to win, and if she manages to repeat what she did in Tokyo, it will be a great boost, and that would help us win more medals. And I am rooting for her. I am rooting for her to go for that gold which she missed in Tokyo. And she's in good form as well. There's no doubt that she's definitely a top contender for that gold medal.
Yeah, absolutely. So she has been consistently performing well in every major world event. So from 2014 Commonwealth Games, where she got the medal, and then 2018 she got gold, 2022 she got gold, and the World Championships in 2022, there also she got a gold. So she's been in great form right now, and we really hope that she can get that elite gold medal for India.